This shows that you two religions are united in suppressing the human rights. You have said that you may say that women are so attractive, but this is a personal perspective. And if you find so, your views are corrupted and your mind is corrupted. The concept of beauty itself is also changing. Once Cleopatra was beautiful, but it is not so. Now Aishwarya Rai ranks first. And you are also suggested for the original text, but it creates only the fanatics and fundamentalists. When you are convinced to a particular religious ideology, you find no wrong in your claims. That is the thing which happened in Gujarat, where 2,000 Muslims are murdered in the streets. No God has come, only communists and some Democrats' efforts were there. People are renouncing all the religious values. And for you like persons, that it has come to as shock values. Religion is failed and not the people. So please allow the people to free and allow them to join their social movements like communists and Naxalbari movements. That is
the brother, I believe, is a communist. He's asked a very good question. He's saying that if Hinduism allows and Krishna has married 16,108 wives and Islam allows, so Hinduism and Islam is joining in suppressing the women, according to you. According to him, brother, he's saying Cleopatra was beautiful, today she is not. Aishwarya Rai is number one. For you, not for me. So what is beautiful for you may not be beautiful for me. I do agree with you. It is a perspective. I do agree with you. Aishwarya Rai may be number one for you, not for me. So we realize, brother, the concept of difference changes. And I give the example. What is modest in America is not modest here. What is modest here is not modest in America. Who's to decide? I do agree with you. If you think that marrying more than one wife is suppressing the woman, who's going to take care of the millions of women? You. Who will take care? Will your communist movement take care? Allah, in the glorious Quran, gives you the solution to the problem of humankind. The solution doesn't go down your throat. I'm asking you a question today. There are millions and millions of women more than men. Who's going to take care of them? Who? Even if you give them charity every month, that charity will not be sufficient. See, man and woman have been made sexual by nature. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Rum, chapter number 30, verse 21, He has put love and mercy between their hearts. I am a medical doctor. A woman cannot remain virgin throughout her life. Cannot. It's not possible. What are you going to do? What will happen? They go to prostitution. What will a communism do for them? What is the solution? No solution. Allah gives the solution, our Creator. The solution doesn't go down the throat. So the problem is, brother, the solution is that you give a better solution. Can you think of a better solution? In Islam, it's not compulsory to marry more than one wife. It's not compulsory to marry four. I don't know of a single Indian Muslim who has got four wives. I don't know of any. There are other foreigners Muslim who have got. You have to realize, brother, this is the solution. Everyone cannot marry more than one woman. Everyone cannot. But certain men who can do justice between the wife, Allah has given them permission. If they can do justice, what is troubling you? I don't understand. Where are we suppressing them? We are uplifting them. The so-called modernity you're talking about in America in the name of art and culture, what are they doing? They're degrading the woman. Your talk of women's liberalization is nothing but it is an exploitation of a body, degradation of honor and deprivation of a soul. The Western society claiming to uplift the woman have actually degraded her to a concubine, to a mistress and society butterflies which are hidden behind the colorful skin of art and culture. In the name of art and culture, Aishwarya Rai, what is that? Modeling, is it right? So the problem is, brother, you have to put your thinking right is important. We don't want to sell our daughters. We don't want to sell our mothers. If you want, you can do it. And the famous ad, I'm told, which I gave the example last time, of the BMW. Someone told me, very famous ad. You know BMW car? It's a very famous car. Youngsters go in competition with Mercedes. In the ad, there's a woman standing in a bikini in front of the ad. Test driver now. Who, the girl or the car? What are you doing? In the name of communism, in the name of uplifting the women, you're selling your daughters, you're selling your mothers. We Muslims don't want to do it. We don't want to do it. In America, you can have mistresses, 5, 10, 20, no one can stop you. So in communism, having mistresses is allowed. Having more than one wife, you have to give her rights, you cannot ill-treat her, you have to give her honor, you have to give her property. That doesn't go down your throat. Who will degrade the woman, you or me? You know, in America, one of the most advanced countries. These Americans who talk about that Islam degrades the woman, do you know, out of those people accepting Islam, today Islam is the fastest growing religion. Out of those people accepting Islam, two-thirds of the people are women. If Islam degrades the woman, then why are the American women accepting Islam? Why are the American men accepting Islam? Who forced Dr. Abu Amna Bilal Fif to accept Islam? Who forced Brother Abdul Rahim Green to accept Islam? Who? If you see the women, two-thirds of the people are women. They're accepting Islam. Why? If Islam degrades the woman, why will they accept Islam? Because they know that Islam gives security to the woman. Islam uplifts women. That security may not go with your purpose of making money in art and culture. Like the politicians, they want to divide and rule. These people of art and culture talking about uplifting the women, beauty contest, they're selling cosmetics. They make billions of dollars. You know that the beauty contest for what? In the name of beauty contest, they're making billions of dollars. So just because they want to make billions of dollars, all of many of them want to go and see. So if you realize, brother, we don't believe in exhibiting of women in front of public. We respect them, we love them, and we revere them. We don't want to degrade them.
We have a non-Muslim sister. Yeah.
The answer that you gave me, your logic and statistics made me think for a while. But I still have a point to be cleared. Probably, at a previous point of time, in those days, men had to go to the battlefield. The only source of income for a family was through men. But now times are changing, and probably in the future, times will still more change, and women might go to the battlefield, and right now women are going for jobs, and probably the mortality rate for women might increase too. At that point of time, is it okay to modify and say that there can be just one wife for a man? After all, religion is for mortal creatures like us and not for God.
That's a very good question. At that time in wars, maybe men were dying more, and I agree with her. Now the times of wars have changed. But even today, sister, in the wars, more men are dying. In the Gulf War, more men died. In the Afghanistan War, more men died. In Vietnam War, more men died. But the percentage was much less as compared to the older. I do agree with you. Today, I gave the statistic, more people are dying of cigarette smoking, they are men rather than women. More people dying of alcoholism, more men than women. Accident, more men than women. I do agree with you that now women start going to the battlefield. And in America, when I was there in USA, just a few years back, they started a women section. Women going, and the big section of women joining the military. Do you know the president of America that time? It was Bill Clinton, I think Bill Clinton. He had to apologize in the parliament. You know, 96 women were raped by the superior. He had to apologize in the parliament. Majority of the women that take part in this battlefield, they are raped by the superior. When you have shoulder to shoulder going to war, what will happen? See, this is statistics. Sister, this is statistics of America. The problem, I do agree with you. Sister, I do agree with your question. Your question is innocent because you don't know the statistics. Do you know the statistics? I do agree women are going for a job. In America, do you know? In America, every day, according to the statistics of 1996, U.S. Department of Justice, 2,713 women are being raped every day. Every 32 seconds, one woman is being raped. We are here in this auditorium for the past 3 hours. For the past 3 hours, more than 300 women may have been raped in U.S. until the time I'm here. Why? Islam is not against women working. Islam is not against women working, but it is the duty of the man to be the bed earner. They can work, but it should be a modest work. It should not be modeling, dancing, singing, or intermingling with the gents. Working is allowed, sister, but if you do those works which are immodest, there are high chances that you may be degraded, there may be immorality. Yes, sister, you have some comments?
I'm not talking about any... degrading the modesty of a woman kind of jobs. I'm talking about modest jobs, say driving itself. There are the number of women drivers in the world are increasing. What at one point of time, let's say of a hypothetical situation, at one point of time, the number of women drivers in the world increase and the mortality rate of women increase. At that point of time, is it okay for us to accept a religion and say that a man can have just one? I'm not just talking about this particular aspect of any religion alone. Any aspect of religion. Is it okay to modify religion as times are changing?
This is a very good question. That can we modify religion as times are changing? If the religion is not perfect, it requires a modification. If the religion is perfect, no modification is required. So if the religion has a problem, therefore I told you, point out a single fault. You are talking hypothetically. Hypothetically, after 100 years, if women start diving, if women die, if women population becomes